Today, let us see how to prepare banana halwa. For this, we can use any variety of banana. Here, I have Kerala Rasthali. This variety will be small, so I am going to use around 8 bananas. Let us grind this into a fine paste. The banana paste is ready, set this aside. Now take a pan, add 2 teaspoons of ghee. Let us fry some assorted nuts in this ghee. Here I have badam and cashews. The nuts are golden brown here, we can take it out. Set the nuts aside and add the banana paste. Stir this continuously for about 2 minutes. You don't need to add any extra ghee here. Now let us add the sugar. It is 1 cup of sugar, 3/4 of the cup. We are going to add it now. I am going to preserve the 1/4 cup for caramelization. Start stirring this continuously. You have to cook this in medium flame. At one stage, after 3 to 4 minutes, this will turn shiny and thick. You can see the consistency. At this stage, you can add around 2 teaspoons of ghee. Keep this in low flame. Now we are going to deal with the 1/4 cup of sugar. Take a bowl, add 1/4 cup of sugar. To this, add a teaspoon of water. Adding water is absolutely optional. You can also avoid water. Just to avoid burning of sugar, I have added little water. Even without water, the sugar will melt. At one stage, it will become golden brown in color. At that stage, you can switch off the flame. This is ready. Now let us pour this into the halwa. This caramelized sugar will give a nice color and flavor to the halwa. Now start stirring this. You have to stir this continuously in medium flame until the halwa consistency arrives. At one stage, your halwa won't stick to the pan and that is the perfect consistency. At that stage, you can add the fried nuts. For the halwa to be little shiny, I'm going to add another 2 teaspoons of ghee. And here our halwa is ready. Next, let us see how to prepare Kashi Halwa or Ash Gourd Halwa. For this, we need 1/2 medium-sized ash gourd. Peel the skin, remove the seeds, cut it into big pieces. Now, let us grate this. Grate this evenly, otherwise it won't get cooked properly. Our ash gourd is ready, set this aside. Add a teaspoon of ghee in a pan. Let us fry few cashew nuts in this ghee. Saute this until it is slightly brown. The cashew nuts are ready, you can take it out and set them aside. Here you already have some ghee in the pan. To this add 1/2 a teaspoon of ghee and then add the grated ash gourd. Saute this in the ghee for about a minute. Usually ash gourd will leave some water, so you don't need to add any extra water. Close this and cook for about 2 minutes. Here you can see that there is no water. The pumpkin is also smooth now. At this stage you can add the sugar. Add 1/4 cup of sugar and a pinch of cardamom. Now saute this until the sugar melts completely. Here the sugar got melted. Let us close this again and cook for another 2 minutes. After some 2 or 3 minutes you can see that the sugar is getting caramelized. The caramelization of the sugar will turn this into a perfect halwa. For the dish to be attractive, I am adding few drops of red color, and if you want to avoid the color, you can avoid it. Stir this continuously until it doesn't stick to the pan. Here you can see that everything came together and it is not sticking to the pan. This is ready. Top it with the fried cashews. This will taste so good, and this is a only halwa you can do with a teaspoon of ghee. Next, let us see how to do carrot halwa. Add a tablespoon of ghee in a pan. To this add few almonds, few cashew nuts and few raisins. Roast everything well and take it out. In the same pan add 2.5 cups of grated carrot. Cook this until it is half cooked and then add 1 cup of boiled milk. Let us close this and cook for 5 minutes. Now the carrot is almost cooked. To this add 2 crushed cardamoms. Here the milk got reduced and the carrot got cooked. At this stage we can add around 1/2 cup of sugar. The sugar got melted. Now you have to stir this continuously until it becomes thick. Add a teaspoon of ghee into this. Once this is thick, you can add the roasted nuts. The carrot halwa is thick and ready. This will taste so good. Next, we are going to see how to prepare jackfruit halwa. For this, we need around 3 cups of jackfruits. Remove the seeds and collect the flesh part. To make the fruit more soft, we are going to pressure cook this. Put it in a pressure cooker, add a cup of water and pressure cook this for 2 to 3 whistles. This is ready. Let us transfer this into a mixie. After it cools down, grind it into a fine jackfruit paste. Is ready. Set this aside. Take a pan, pour 1 teaspoon of ghee in it. To this add about 10 cashew nuts. Fry them. Fry the cashew nuts well. It has to change its color. This is perfect. We can take it out. You don't want to add extra ghee now. In this ghee itself, you can add the jackfruit paste. To this add 1/4 cup of sugar. You can adjust the sugar according to the jackfruit's sweetness. Give a nice stir. Let this cook by itself, lower the flame. Next we are going to prepare corn flour mix. Take 1.5 tablespoon of corn flour. To this add 1/2 cup of water. Give a nice mix. No lump should be formed. Give a nice mix. This is ready. Now we are going to add this into the jackfruit paste. Start stirring continuously. You have to stir this continuously because corn flour will make this thick. Once it is quite thick, we are going to add 1/2 cup of milk into it. Now we have to stir this continuously till halwa consistency arrives. This is thick now. Now let us add the fried cashew nuts into it. Give a nice stir. Once the halwa consistency arrives, it will not stick to the vessel. This is thick now. At this stage, we can add 2 teaspoons of ghee. So now it's not sticking to the vessel. This is perfect. We can take it out. Our jackfruit halwa is ready. Next, let us see how to do sweet corn halwa.
For this, take 1 sweet corn and separate the kernels like this. You can either use sweet corn or the regular maize. Now add this into the mixie jar. Add some water and grind this into a fine paste. The corn paste is ready. Let us filter this. And here I am using some water to clear the corn paste in the mixie. And overall you can use 1 cup of water, not more than that. This is the second set of corn. Let us once again filter this in the same filter. You have to get a fine liquid out of this, so I am going to filter it again with a small filter. This is ready. Now let us transfer this into a pan. Before keeping this on the flame, we have to get ready with the caramelized sugar. For the caramelized sugar, add 4 tablespoons of sugar and 1.5 tablespoons of water. Stir this continuously until the sugar gets caramelized. Once it is golden brown, you have to take it out of the flame. If you overcook, it will give a bitter taste. Now let us start stirring the corn water. Keep the flame in medium and start stirring this. Once this starts getting thick, you can add the caramelized sugar. Now stir this continuously until it becomes thick. Once this is thick, you can add the sugar. You can add around 1/2 cup to 3/4 cup of sugar. Now stir this until you get the halwa consistency. The sugar has melted and this has become little shiny. At this stage you can add around 2 teaspoons of ghee and 1 crushed cardamom. After this, if you stir this for about a minute, your halwa is ready. If you want, you can stop here. Otherwise, I'm going to add some raisins into this. I'm adding 1 teaspoon of ghee and I'm going to fry some raisins. And this sort of frying is only suitable for raisins. If you're going to fry cashews, fry them separately and add it into the halwa. So here our halwa is ready, we can take it out now. Next, let us see how to do banana wheat halwa. For this, take a cup of wheat flour. Add enough water little by little and make this into a soft dough. Knead this well for some time. Kneading will help you to get the gluten out of the flour. And that will be little helpful for making halwa. After kneading, add 1.5 cups of water. Now let us dissolve the dough in the water. It has to be like this. Now let us filter this once. Filtering is over. Now let us give this rest for at least 15 to 20 minutes. By the time, take a pan, add 2 teaspoons of ghee. We are going to fry some raisins. If you want, you can add few cashew nuts or some other nuts. Raisins are ready, we can take it out now. Now in the leftover ghee, I'm going to mash and add 3 bananas. Saute this well in medium flame for few minutes. Let the bananas get cooked well, so keep it in medium flame and cook for at least 5 to 10 minutes. Coming to the wheat mixture, you can see some water on the top. You have to remove it and add it. Try to carefully remove the water, as because we are adding less water, we'll get only less water on the top. To be little cautious, I have switched off the flame. Give a nice mix and set this aside for few minutes. Now take a pan, add 1 tablespoon of sugar and a little water. We are going to caramelize this. This caramelization will give a nice flavor and color for the halwa. If you want your halwa to be little more dark, you have to add more sugar. Here I have added the banana wheat mixture into the caramelized sugar. Give a nice mix and keep it on the flame. Start stirring this continuously for about 5 minutes in medium flame. After 5 minutes, you can add around 1/2 cup of sugar. Your bananas will have sweetness, so if you want, you can reduce the sugar. Now start stirring this continuously until you get the halwa consistency. This is after 5 minutes, this has become little shiny now. At this stage, you can add around 3 to 4 teaspoons of ghee. Again, keep the flame low and start stirring this. You can add the fried nuts at this stage. This is ready now for the banana halwa. This is the consistency. At this stage, you can switch off the flame. Apply little ghee on a plate and transfer the halwa into it. For a nice shine, add a little ghee on the top. Now shape it.
Now let us wait for it to cool down. Once it cools down completely, you can cut them into pieces. So here our halwa is ready. Next, let us see how to do pumpkin halwa. For the recipe, we need a small pumpkin. You have to peel the skin and grate it. Add 3 to 4 tablespoons of ghee in a pressure cooker. We are going to fry some assorted nuts. This is badam, pista, cashews and raisins. The nuts are fried well. We can take it out now. You have sufficient ghee inside the cooker, but let me add 1 more teaspoon and add the grated pumpkin. Now let us saute this for a few minutes. We are going to pressure cook this later, so you can saute this for about 2 or 3 minutes and then add the sugar. Add 1/2 cup of sugar and saute this until the sugar melts. Here you can see that the sugar has completely melted. At this stage, you can add 1 cup of milk. This has started boiling, so now we can close this and pressure cook. The pumpkin is soft now. Let's add a pinch of cardamom powder. We are going to saute this until we get the halwa consistency. Let us add a teaspoon of ghee into this. Let us now add the fried nuts. The consistency will be more similar to carrot halwa. So here our pumpkin halwa is ready. Let us transfer this into another bowl. Our next recipe is coconut halwa or barfi. For this, add a teaspoon of ghee in a pan. To this, I am going to add 1 full scraped coconut. Let us saute the coconuts in ghee until it is slightly brown. Here you can see the change in color. This is perfect. You can switch off the flame. Once it cools down, you can transfer this into a mixie jar. Let us grind this once. We have crumbled this. Now add some water and grind it into a fine paste. The paste is ready. It has to be like this. In the same pan, I am going to add 1/2 a cup of beetroot juice. And for the juice, I have used 1 full beetroot and 1/4 cup of water. Bring it to a boil and stir this continuously. Let this gets reduce a little. Now let us add around 1/2 a cup of sugar. Stir this continuously. The sugar has to melt. Let this be on the flame until it becomes slightly sticky. You can touch and examine like this. If it is slightly sticky, you can add the coconut paste. Now start stirring this continuously. You are using coconut paste, so once it starts boiling, you have to close and cook. otherwise it will splatter here and there, so close and cook carefully. Once it becomes thick, you can normally stir this. Until then, do not open the lid fully. Now it has become thick for me, so I can open the lid. Now stir this continuously until it becomes thick. The consistency of this halwa is similar to the carrot halwa consistency. The halwa is ready. You can serve it like this, or if you want, you can spread some ghee in a pan and spread this. Even if it cools down, this won't become so thick like burfi. But this will taste so good with some condensed milk or ice cream. So we are going to prepare our own condensed milk here. Take a cup of milk. Let this boil and get reduced. The milk has become thick now. At this stage, you can add around 2 or 3 tablespoons of sugar. Stir this continuously until you get a creamy consistency. This is perfect. You can spread this on the halwa. Once it cools down completely, you can cut them into small pieces. Do give a try. This will taste so good. Hope you like the recipe. We'll join you in another interesting recipe, and don't forget to subscribe our channel.